What is your name?
Hi, my name is Quetia Osario.
And what's going on here today?
So today is the 7th annual Big Latch On, which is a breastfeeding event that we do every year just to show support for families who are breastfeeding. We know that breastfeeding saves lives. It is a living organism, milk, human milk for human babies. It provides antibodies and immunities just to support, you know, first food, support new humans into the world and protect them. So, and also nourish and feed them and grow them. So yeah, that's what we're doing here. It's led by this wonderful team, Selena Tang, who is our baby cafe facilitator, and Leslie, who's like her awesome co-partner in this work. And they've been doing it, I'm gonna say, for like 6 years now. So for like, 6 years, I have been attending this ever since I started Chocolate Milk Cafe here in Providence, Rhode Island. And that was in what, 2016? So it's been 5 years. We just celebrate it, and yeah, so we show our support and solidarity. We come and we show up and we support all the breastfeeding mamas and persons.
Right. And so you seem really knowledgeable about the doula bill.
Yes.
That recently passed. When I first walked up here, I heard you talking about that, I believe.
Yeah.
But yeah. I was wondering if you could just give us a brief description of it.
Sure. So basically the doula bill legislation recently passed, and thank you to all of our community, all our legislative team, our policy team, strategy team, every single person who sent an email, you know, did a testimony. Thank you guys so much, because it was a 3-year community effort, and I believe everyone came together to get this equitable and just service for families, you know, as they expand and expect new members. And so the doula bill basically is legislative policy that talks about the evidence-based practice of doula services helping to mitigate adverse birth outcomes and maternal health situations, such as birthing persons having too many interventions or not enough cesareans, not feeling empowered, not having informed consent. And so basically what a doula does is they come in, they're kind of like, I always tell people, like a triangle in which we support the family. So it's both, you know, birthing person and partner, mom, dad, however their identifier is, and we just come in as like another, you know, third leg to add in that stability. So me as a doula, I provide childbirth education, lactation education, labor and delivery support, as well as postpartum care. And so with this legislation, it actually allows reimbursement for doulas to be paid, because all families deserve a doula and all doulas deserve to be paid for this work. And so it's really built off the premise of Black maternal health outcomes. Black moms, birthing persons die 3 to 4 times greater in the state of Rhode Island than our white counterparts. And so this was just an attempt really to create an equitable service to those who wouldn't and didn't have access before. And so really Black and brown families who wanted doula services but just couldn't afford them, didn't have the financial means, and doulas who, you know, like myself, who for the past, 6 years, have been really like piecemealing things together so that we could provide the support, doing scholarships, you know, doing broader services, you know, running one service, putting money towards another, just so that we could provide these supports. And now we actually can say, okay, we're just going to reimburse, you know, put in for insurance to reimburse that we can get paid to really do this work, because it takes a lot to be a doula. It's not easy.
Yeah. And I think you mentioned the statistics about Black women. And
yes.
You also mentioned that this is the year that it passed. And I was wondering, do you feel like this has any connection to the social movement that happened last year?
So
it was the year that this passed, and then it also is related to Black women.
No, because this has been, Black maternal health disparities have been ongoing, right? Like, this has been a constant fight in the community, a constant movement. I do feel as though that there has just been this, you know, surge that has come up over the past few years on really honing in on racial and racial equity and justice. And it's coming in all at the same time. Like, people, you know, they want better civil rights, they want more social justice, they want more equity. And I think that it's just been a culmination of things that's coming up over the years. Like, we've all been in this resistance, we've all been fighting for this. And so this isn't like a new movement or a new wave. This is something that has been consistent, but it's finally bubbled up to the top to be a priority. And so this year, it passing has been great. I think the only reason why it didn't pass last year is because COVID obviously took precedence and was a priority. But we had great support last year. And this year, you know, it's passing successful. It doesn't officially kick off to July 2022. I have to say that because we get a lot of calls from people who are like, hey, insurance coverage. It's not there yet, but I can tell you the doula community has been moving swiftly, advantageously, effectively, efficiently on making sure that we are ready in July 2022 to take on families. And it is a lot of work because it's very new. It's not just a service. It's identifying doulas as providers, and that is huge. So our bill is actually the first in the nation. Very, very proud of that for our build particular structure and type. And we was intentional, and I can honestly say it really is the integrity of the team to making sure that we moved forward with the bill that was the right bill. We didn't want to create something that was going to be adverse, that was going to do any type of harm. We wanted to make sure that there was a bill that really spoke to not only Black maternal health, but also spoke to maternal health, like on a basis across the board. And so our bill is not only Medicaid, it is also private insured and commercial insurers. And that was really the flagstone for this bill, because Black maternal health is regardless of, you know, socioeconomic status. So it doesn't matter if you're affluent Black living in the community. When you go into some of these hospitals, you're just seen as Black. And we saw that with Serena Williams. We saw that, you know, with, you know, the unfortunate demise of Kara Johnson. We saw that with Beyonce, where Black women are not listened to inside these industries, inside these complexes, where you're still treated, you know, with race medicine. And even though we know race is a social construct, you're still being treated that way. And so this kind of like provides an opportunity for someone to get that education, for someone to get that support that they weren't receiving. And it's not on the responsibility of the provider to do all of these things. And so this is a key piece for me. This legislation is about providing service also to the providers as well as the families.
Thank you. That was really amazing. I think you really described it really well. I'll let you go so you can say whatever
right.
you want. Thank you so much.
Hell yeah!